don't know what's wrong with Britain today. Bonnie Greer was last night, as we are led to believe, giving it to Nick Griffin. She brought a book along, I think. I don't know. She said, I'll go in this book. And she argued with him that there's no indigenous Britons. There's no white indigenous Britons of Britain. English. But while she's doing, taking people apart that are British, white British, she didn't go back and argue the case. You know, she's all right. That's just a stance, right? You're dismantling Britain. But she didn't go back and say, oh, so we should also get rid of the race laws. She didn't do that. This is racist. She just attacked white people in Britain. She said, you don't exist. That's nice. There's no ethnic British. And I've heard it a lot on the media all today. It's wall-to-wall coverage. And there's no ethnic British. There's no indigenous British. There's no British people. There's no English people. Funny that. When it suits. But it still applies when there's a race law to be fought. There's still race laws. There's no ethnic British, there's no white people. You know, you're like ghosts, you don't exist. This government, this left-wing government, left-wing media have taken away the English identity. It doesn't exist. Think what you will about the BNP. They have no right to do that. I exist. Look, here I am. I exist in, right? And so, what they've done, is said you only exist as a sop for like when it's needed, like you're to be differentiated out from other people, and when you can be biased, then you exist. Apart from that, you don't exist. There's no ethnic British, there's no indigenous British. So, where was this Bonnie Greer? When they charged him, right, and charged this Nick Griffin, saying his party, they were being biased towards indigenous Caucasians. Indigenous means like a minority, really, but it's been taken over by another culture, other people, the indigenous people, like American Indians, right? And Caucasian, well, that means whatever you think it means, because it's like made up thing in the past. It means, sometimes it meant included Indians, sometimes not. So you've got a sort of a terminology of indigenous, meaning some people of that land, and Caucasian, meaning some pseudo-scientific grouping of people, some pseudo-genetic term. And they've lumped them together and charged the BNP with that, being biased. So then exists, then there is an indigenous Caucasian people. When it suits them to put into law. But did Bonnie Greer argue that that shouldn't have been the case, that BNP shouldn't be charged with racism? No. So that's hypocrisy, isn't it? You can exist enough to be tortured by the law and what have you, but you don't exist enough to have a right of self-defense. To say, I exist, and I want my kind to exist over another kind. You know, I want some barriers around me, please, because I want to like exist. I have the right to exist. They're saying you don't exist, and that's why everyone can come to this country. Yeah, there's a woman in the audience, right? She said, she corrected some woman in the panel. She said, I am African Caribbean. Right, and Bonnie Greer didn't say nothing. She, oh yeah, that's right. She's got her ethnic rights there. That's where she came from. That's what she's declaring as her roots. Right, I'm an African Caribbean. And yet Bonnie Greer doesn't say, oh, and you too, Nick Griffin, you know, and all the white people of England, you too can have an ethnic. No, she takes that away. You don't have an ethnic origin. You don't exist. And then she whacked him with what was it? Well, whack the British people with you all come from Africa stuff. When the Ice Age went, you all come out of Africa. Well, thank you. But does that really encapsulate what indigenous means in today's terminology? Not really. So she can attack the white British people and say, you don't come from nowhere, you're like the Moggy race, right? Oh, thank you very much. But does he do that to other people? This is just that they're Indians. Oh, you come out of Africa. No, she doesn't say peep. Bonnie Greer is very selective, and I think that's hypocrisy. And then people are going, oh, she's crazy, took him to task. No, she didn't. She's just hypocritical. And she just dismissed the English people. And I just caught this bloody right stuff, and Rick Reeves was it, saying, oh, the people in this country should go and learn history, because they don't know that half the time we come from France. Well, he doesn't know what France is made up of, does he? Because they were Celts, like us, and Germanic, like us. Like the Vikings that landed there, the Normans. So what you've got with both of those statements, really, is both countries, France and Britain, you've got a Celtic underlay with a Germanic tribe overlay, right? Germanic overlay of that. So your Vikings that landed in Normandy, the Vikings that landed in Britain, and the Vikings landed in France on the Franks, who were a Germanic tribe, the Anglo-Saxons, who were a Germanic tribe. It's all Germanic tribes. See, what they've got in today's Britain going on the media is they're confusing, on purpose I think, different Germanic cultures and tribes, right, with actual race. They're saying, well, that's come from France, so it's like a different race. No, it's the same mix, Celtic language, and then a Germanic language tribal overlay on top of that, right? It's the same people, the same mob. You got Celts, Franks, Vikings that make up the Normans that came to Britain. Now, they wasn't welcomed with open arms, they were fought. 1066 and all that, learn your history. And then the Huguenots, they were welcomed in, but that goes by the French leaders around those times. So, and the French court and that sort of thing, sort of a hangover. So were they welcomed in all that much? I don't think so. Definitely not in 1066. See those pitched battles. And that's the other thing Germaine Greer came out as, mixing the British and demolishing him. She said, well, the Romans were here, so the Romans left. The African mercenaries left Britain. And if there was some intermingling between the Celts and Celts, not Germanic tribes, and the Romans, then that might have got swept away when even the Anglo-Saxons turned up and replaced the what we call now called England with their genetic makeup. And that is, you can go look at that up as well, the Anglo-Saxons, how they replaced the Celts in England to a lesser or greater degree. The other thing they hit Nick Griffin with was you don't like a number of sections or minorities of people, and that's what made him a horrible person, because he wasn't fond or too fond of these people. That's really for him to answer, and I can't answer for him. But I just wonder who else is so fond of all these minorities. You interchange these minorities with their ruling classes in their actual own field, you mix them up, and they don't tolerate each other themselves. So you have to be fair here, right? So one of them was gays, right? So how many gays run the Church of England? How many gays run the Church of England? Jews. How many Jews run Iran? Catholics. How many Catholics run Israel? EU, anti-EU. How many pop stars run the EU? Muslims, how many Muslims run India? Hindus. How many women run India? And you go down the list like that, of all minorities. You mix them up and you put them in their system of whatever the top organisation of that body is, and you mix them up. And they don't tolerate each other. That's the truth of it.